Our first daily headline is winter chill. Super Agent Scott Boras, as you just heard at the top of the show, spoke out today at the winter meetings about a number of topics. But one of them, as we played for you, was the Mets and their spending. Boras saying the Mets need to open the vault. Now, of course, Boras is an agent who wants everyone to open up their vault. And the Mets did sign reliever Anthony Swarzak to a two-year, $14 million deal today to bolster the bullpen. But we know that doesn't qualify as big spending in this day and age of baseball. Sal, what's your reaction to what Boras said about the Mets today? And keep in mind, it's a recent trend for Boras, who in the past has done his weird supermarket aisle comparisons and everything else. So he likes doing this sort of thing.
Yeah, I'm sick of hearing from Scott Boras, to be honest with you. I have been for many years. He rips the Mets nonstop. It's obvious what he wants. When the Mets are in play for big free agents, his clients have a chance to get more money, use more leverage. So obviously he has his best interest in mind here. And if I'm the Mets, I wouldn't even deal with him. Now, that being said, this was a huge offseason for the Mets. I felt that all year long, maybe the largest since 2009. And I thought the Mets needed to go out there and at least be in the mix for some marquee free agents. I'm not saying they need to go out there and give a guy 8 years for, you know, $200 million, whatever it may be, because payroll doesn't always win. But they need players. And if they're not going to trade for some players, if they don't have the guys in the minor league system to make trades, then you're going to have to go out there and buy some players. And I'm not getting the sense that the Mets are going to be in on any big free agents in what I thought was a huge offseason for them. Let it play out. But as of now, the Mets haven't gotten in on any big marquee free agents.
Yeah, I feel like Scott Boras, not only was he going after the Mets, he was basically going after everybody. He was going after the Marlins. I actually think he thinks the winter meetings are some type of roast, because he comes in almost with like these prepared statements and these zingers.
He called the Marlins a pawn shop.
Yes, exactly. Exactly. So I'm sure Jeter wasn't happy about that. But with that being said, he has a point here. I mean, granted, we all know who he is. We all know he's profiting from a team like the Mets opening up their vault. But at the same time, I think fans are waiting for a big deal. When they had Cespedes and they brought him on, I feel like that's the last big kind of move where people were really excited about something. And with having about, I think, $60 million come off the payroll, you have money there. So it's just a matter of how much are you willing to spend and who are you going to spend it on? And I think we're just waiting. Mm.
I think he's trying to capitalize too on, like, the Yankees made this huge trade, right?
Right.
And he knows that the Mets and the Yankees in this town, like, the Mets owned this town not long ago.
Right.
And now they suddenly don't. And I think he sees what the Yankees did and he says, hey, I represent a guy like Eric Hosmer. You know, if the Mets are coming after him and they don't want to pay for him, let me play on the heartstrings a little bit. Let me play on the fact that the Mets want to measure up to the Yankees in New York.
Play to the psychology of the fan base?
No question. I think it's all that. It's the public negotiations, but not, as you said, not just to the organization, but to the fan base and to people who want to see the Mets match what the Yankees do and then better them like they did a couple years ago.